Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to a new video. In today's video, I want to talk about Prince from Forex Empire, that has an account management program with a low buy-in that promises great returns, but nothing ever comes from it. Okay, so like I said, today we are talking about Prince from Forex Empire, and before you guys get confused and think I'm talking about another Prince, just to be sure, we are talking about this Prince, and late in the video, we will actually verify that it is him. So like I said, he has a low buy-in account management program that promises great returns, but nothing ever comes from it. And this is the experience of one person named Zahir. Okay, so when Zahir approached Prince from Forex Empire for account management, you can see that Zahir first approached him through his Instagram. Now, what I want you guys to pay close attention to is the fact that Zahir already had a number that he got from Instagram from Prince, but they actually just wanted to make sure that it is the right number. Another thing that I also want you guys to take notice of is the banking details seen in here in the Instagram chats. Please take note of that, as that you will see come forth in the WhatsApp chats as well. Now, going on to the WhatsApp chats, you will see that Zahir asked him how much is the buy-in, to which Prince then says it's on special for 1000 Rand. Now, the 1000 Rand doesn't just mean 1000 Rand. It means that Zahir has to pay 2000 Rand. 1000 Rand is for the account management for Prince, and then the other 1000 Rand would go towards account funding. And although I don't have any problems with account management programs or investment programs with low buy-ins that isn't FSAA registered, what actually really blew my mind is the fact that this guy is out here promising great returns. So when Zahir asked him, what is the return? What can I expect? Prince then says 20,000 Rand. Now, take into consideration, guys, Prince told him that you can make 20,000 Rand from 1,000 Rand. That is a big red flag already. And to top it all off, Prince then wants to take another 20% of this money. Now, please take note that, like I said earlier, Zahir already paid 1,000 Rand for account management. That is the account management fee. So what is this 20% about? Now, before I go any further, I know there's a whole lot of you that just likes to put the blame on the consumer, and I know at some point I have to be realistic as well and put the blame on the consumer, but in this instance I really cannot put the blame on Zahir, as what he followed through on, in my experience, I will follow through on as well. Now, what do I mean by that? I mean by that Zahir asked this guy, what will happen to my money if you lose it? Now, we all know that when you lose money, you cannot get it back ever. But Prince then told Zahir, listen, if you lose your money, I'm going to give you a refund. And to be sure, Zahir asked again and again and again. And as you can see, that was Prince's constant reply. Now, for me, this is just to extract money, just to get money out of people, because if he's out there saying that I am gonna give you a refund, why hasn't the refund happened already? Okay, so as you guys can see, Zahir then went forth with his decision. He joined Prince's account management program. As you guys can see, here is the proof of payments. He then really waited for Prince to work on his account. Now, account management works like this. I pay you a fee, and then you will work on my account. I will give you the login details, and then I will see the progress that you make on my account. But Zahir then saw that nothing happened, and this is where issues just jumped up randomly. So the first issue that popped up by Prince is the fact that he said Zahir needs to fund his account. Now, going back to the costs that was discussed in the very first stages of the conversation, the 1000 Rand that Prince is quoting Zahir is meant to be 2000 Rand. 1000 Rand is for admin fee, and the other 1000 Rand is for the account funding. So I do not know why Prince is telling him to fund again. And the other thing I also found really suspicious is that he wanted Zahir to pay 2000 Rand admin fee and 1000 Rand as an investment. So guys, look at this. Why would someone be out here charging 2000 Rand but is taking 1000 Rand investment? Something doesn't sound right here. Why is the investment smaller than what you are paying for someone to do the investments? Why? So as I said, Zahir saw that nothing was happening on this account, which then prompted him to tell Prince, listen here, Give me my deposit back rather. You keep the 1000 rand for the account management and I'll come back when you are ready to trade my money. Which I feel is a really logical solution to this whole issue. But I also feel like this is where things went sideways, because it's always when you ask people for your money back that the excuses really starts to pop up. The third issue that popped up that Prince used to his opportunity to deny service and to deny a refund in total was the fact that Zaire's number changed. Now, I'm not gonna be disingenuous here and blame Prince entirely because when Zaire's number changed, right, Prince doesn't have any chat history with that number. So when Zaire spoke to Prince for the first time with this number, it seemed like a whole new number with no name attached to it. So we can give Prince the benefit of the doubt for denying this at first. But what then happened, what was smart on Zaire's end, he then screenshot their exchange on Instagram. He also screenshot their exchange on WhatsApp since the beginning. And then also, what makes matters really relevant and really helpful for Zaire is the fact that he still had his proof of payments. At this point, Prince should have let his guard down and should have given the service to Zaire that he promised he was going to give, or give Zaire's money back, because this shows irrefutable evidence that this is Zaire. Look here, you can always say that, okay, numbers changed and stuff like that, right? But when it comes to Instagrams, if I have access to your inbox, that means I know your PIN, and I doubt that is the case with Zaire. So what I'm saying is, if Zaire switched numbers, that wouldn't have affected the Instagram inboxes at all. So the inboxes of Instagram was verification enough to me. But the fact that Zaire sent proof of payments and Prince then still pushed back, still showed resistance, just really is off to me. It's disingenuous to me, because why were you saying that you're going to give the money back in the first place? Like I said, it's when you ask for your money back from these Forex account managers that things get a little bit tough. And as you can see, this is where replies are starting to get delayed. This is where Prince is starting to have a little bit of an attitude with Zaire. At some point, Prince did take accountability and responsibility and said that he will pay this money out of his own pocket to Zaire, which I found really, really funny, because why are you saying you must pay it out of your own pocket? If you are the CEO of Forex Empire, that means you're gonna pay it out of your pocket anyway. So why are you trying to softening up this whole situation now when you had a whole attitude the whole time? This is just a bunch of nonsense to me. And as you can see, as noted in the chats, this dragged on for 3 months, almost 4 months, and Prince still didn't pay this guy's money back. Prince still didn't take accountability. Prince still didn't give what he said he was gonna give. And this I find highly disingenuous, especially since Prince said that if I lose your money, I'm gonna give you your money back. But now it didn't even get to that level. This guy just wants his money back. He doesn't even want profits, he just wants his money back. During this 3 to 4 month time period, while he didn't want to pay Zaire, Prince was obviously flexing like every normal young trader would. So I found it really disingenuous that he made this guy wait so long. But what I found really, really worrying is the fact that he said that he cannot pay out Zaire because he is under investigation and his bank card is blocked. So why are you under investigation? Why is your bank card blocked? This is all just big red flags to me. And while the back and forth still went on for a long while, Prince then altogether stopped replying to Zaire. And as you can see, yeah, Zaire was constantly trying to hear from Prince, constantly trying, okay, when I'm gonna get my money back, just wanting to get a response from Prince. And as you can see, Prince ignored this guy entirely after having received 2000 rand from him. 1000 rand for account management and 1000 rand which was gonna be funded into the account. Which leads me to my conclusion. If you are a whole millionaire out there driving BMWs, a whole CEO of a company, why are you taking so long to pay a 2,000 rand? This is someone that have clearly shown that he has paid you. This is someone that has proof of payment that he gave you money. What's taking you so long to pay him? It's just the 2,000 rand. You guys are out here posting profits every single day. I bet if you guys go to Prince's Instagram right now and look from January up until now, you will probably see that this guy have been posting profits non-stop. Obviously to get clients into his business, but if you've been making profits non-stop and if that profits are real, why haven't you paid Zahir yet, even though you said you do give refunds? Another thing, why is your business card blocked? Why are you under investigation? Does this mean that there's other cases? Does this mean that this isn't the first time? Does this mean that people have gone and gotten the law involved? I don't know. You help me. Why is your card blocked and why are you under investigation? Clearly you're not giving Zahir a response, so we have to come to a public platform to ask for your response. Now, one thing I'm gonna do for you guys is I'm gonna put up the videos of the two chats by Prince and Zahir. I'm gonna put the video up of the chats of the Instagram chats, and I'm gonna put up the video of the chats in WhatsApp so you guys can see for yourselves what really went on. If you came this far, I thank you for watching. Please smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. And if you're new here, I welcome you to my channel. It would be awesome if you became a subscriber. On that note, ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.